Hello friends, welcome to J Academy. In this video I am going to show you how to display the data of the nodes in CSLL. So let us see the scenarios here. So here we are going to have three scenarios. The first scenario is that in the case one you have no nodes, in the second case we have only one node, and in the third case we have a few nodes in the linked list, okay, in the CSLL. So now how will you understand there is no node in the CSLL? And if there is no node in the CSLL, so what are you going to print? So the first condition is that to understand there is no node in the linked list, we have to write if head is equal to null. If head is equal to null, it indicates that there is no node in the list. So in this case we will print a message: list is empty, or nothing to display. Both we can write, okay. So this is when the first scenario where you don't have any node. In the second scenario you have only one node. So how will you understand you have only one node? The condition to understand that there is only one node is that if head's link is equal to head, that means the link is having the address of its own self. So in that case we'll understand there is only one node, okay. So we are going to write the condition: if head's link is equal to head, then in that case how are we going to print the data? We'll just write printf percentage d, then using the heads data we will print. So we write heads pointing to the data that we have to print. So this is how we can print when we have only one node, okay. Then if we have a couple of nodes like this, where head is pointing to the first node which is having a data of 100, and the first node is having address of another node which is having a value of 200, and this is having 300, and it is connected to another node with a value of 400, and then this link is having the address of the first node. So whenever you get a scenario in this way, how are we going to print the data? We cannot use the head because head is going to point to the first node. Then in that case the logic is we are going to take a pointer which will point to the head, and then we are going to print this first node data, that is value, and after displaying that value the pointer should move it to the second node, display, go to the third node, display, and go to the fourth node, and it can come out of the loop, and one more time it has to be displayed, because this moving the pointer, that condition becomes false. We have to print one more time after the loop. So how are we going to do it? So we are taking a pointer called temp1, and then we are displaying and moving, displaying and moving till we come to the last node. So let us write the code for this. So we are going to write temp1 is equal to head. So that means the first thing is that temp1 should point to the first node, right? After that we have to write the while loop: while temp1's link, okay, how will you understand it has come to the last node? That I have told you in the previous video. So just think, we can understand that it has come to the last node if the link's address is not equal to head, okay. So we are telling that temp's link not equal to head, okay. Temp1's link is not equal to head. We have to do certain things. What we have to do? First, we have to print the data where the pointer is pointing to. So we are going to print it, temp1's data. So when you are doing temp1's data, it is pointing here to the first node. it will print 100, and then we want it to move to the next one. So we are going to write temp1 equals temp1's link, right? So when we write this, so temp1 we will point to the second node, okay? We will close it. So let us see the how the loop is working, okay? So we'll see this. So temp1 data after printing, it will move it to the second one, okay, second node. Then again it will check the condition, temp1's link not equal to head, it is true, it is not equal to head. Then print the data and move to the next node. Again it will check the condition, temp1's link not equal to head, no, it is not equal to head. Then again print it and go to the next one. But when the temp comes to the last node, here what happens, temp1's link is equal to head. So this condition of while becomes false. So that is why when it comes to the last node, it will come out of the loop. Then you have to print this one more time. Okay. You have to again use a printf statement, and then you have to print the data of the last node. So after the while loop, you again have to write like this and then close the your braces. So this is what, you know, this is how you can print your data, okay, in a CSLM. So now let us combine the entire code in one shot and write the function for displaying in the CSLM. So I have a coding space here, okay, and we are going to see how we are going to do it, right? So first of all, we are going to name this as display, okay, and then we require a couple of pointers, okay. We require a couple of pointers. We are going to use a pointer for temp. Okay, this is one pointer we are using here. So we are going to declare that. So we'll say struct node star temp, and then start our displaying. So first condition is that if head equal to null, then print, okay, the list is empty, okay. So okay, so we are, I'll type here. So if head equals null, okay, then printf list is empty, okay, else if head's link equals head, that means there is only one node. So in that case, you have to print a percentage d heads data. Okay. Else, we'll come to the third condition, right? Okay. So else what will happen, we'll come to the third condition, this condition, right? So this condition we're going to come here. So we'll write here, we are going to put the pointer to the place where head is pointing to, okay, and then using a loop we are going to first print, and then so we're going to write temp1's link not equal to head. Okay, we are going to first print the data. So percentage d heads data, but here it's not heads data, it's temp's data. So we'll make the changes here, temp1's data, okay, and then move your temp1 from that node to the next node. So that is what temp1 equal to temp1's link. So once it is done, we'll close the while loop, and one more time we have to print it, because once it comes to the last node, this condition becomes false. So we have to print it one more time, and then we close the braces. So this brace that we are closing, it is for the else, and one more brace you close it for the function. So that is all about, you know, displaying the element in a CSLM. I hope you have found it very useful. So please like, subscribe and share my channel and keep watching. Thank you.